Guesty, Borough Fan TV, Moatside, the Riverside. We beat Barnsley 3-1. I have Big Steve with me. Steve, first half, excellent football.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? It was perfect first half. We're all sat there at half time thinking, Jesus, where's this been all season? And then I'll let you introduce the second half. How bad was that? That was poor. It was like Jekyll and Hyde.
It took Besic off. They were creating problems even before Besic went off. Obviously, we leave 20 minutes before the end of the game. So let us know, Steve, what's going on.
Well, what did I say to you about Besic? Randolph was my sign of the season. He's only been here a month and he's topped that. That boy, chuck the checkbook at Bill Kenwright. Whatever you want for him, we'll pay it. Doesn't matter what it is, we'll pay it. As soon as he went off, we felt a bit. He's like the pin that holds us together. We looked absolutely terrible after that. We sat off him too deep. We were way too deep. I don't know what Adama was doing. He wandered off in his own little position. I mean, where was the control? Where was the formation? Nothing worked for 25 minutes after he went off.
Why does that happen to us, even if Besic stays on? Why does that happen to us, Steve?
We sit back. We sit back on them. And I don't know why we sit back. If you're 3-0 up, you watch the top side who were 3-0 up. Look at Wolves. Wolves Wednesday night went to Leeds, didn't they? And they were beating them 3-0. Did Wolves sit back? They didn't, did they? They brought players off the bench like Ben Akafobi. Come on. They were chasing, they thought, right, now we've got them at the weakest. Let's have 4, let's have 5, let's have 6. You know what I mean? We sat back, we went, that'll do. No, it won't do. Because look what happened. That could have easily been 3-3, that. We let them on to us big time and we got away with that.
Oh, yeah, they hit the post as well after the scored, Steve.
Yeah. It was Adama ran in one-on-one. He had Baker alongside him. He was 2-on-1 with the keeper. All you had to do was just slide it across. Greedy bastard. Play the bastard ball. We're 3-1 up. Just play it. He never. And then all of a sudden they broke on us, got a chance, got a corner, and hit the bar of the post. They hit the rub work. They could have easily scored that. They scored that. All of a sudden our asses are gone. Any team would go at 3-0 down. 3-0 to 3-2, your arse would go, wouldn't it? And we were all nervous as well, still in the stands. That wasn't good enough to last 25 minutes.
Maybe five, six, seven players out there today under Pulis who've been totally transformed, the form, the confidence, since they've come back into the side. The bloke has done miracles since he came in.
Oh, he's a miracle worker, isn't he? The Messiah. What does AJ call him?
The G.
The G. I don't know where he gets the fucking G from, but you know what I mean? He's worked miracles, hasn't he? He was again, wasn't he? All 90 minutes, fucking dancing on ice, all around that bastard technical area. Big Dave Kemp stood behind him. He looks like, it's like, they're like Jekyll and Hyde. He does all the work and Dave just stood there. He must be the brains behind him. You know what I mean? Ask any West Brom fan, when Dave Kemp left, Tony Pulis went to shit. Dave Kemp is the brains behind Tony Pulis. Exclusive. And they look, it was like, you say the calmness. You say Dave just goes up to him, he gives him a little tap on the shoulder and goes, that. And all of a sudden you see Tony Pulis flinging six fucking arms about, you know what I mean? His passion is incredible. I love the man. I really, really do. It's such an opposite from Gary Monk, isn't it? You know what I mean? I was a fan of Gary Monk, I will admit that. But he was just stood there, hands in his chinos. Doesn't matter, we're only 3-0 down. Doesn't matter. Pulis, 3-0 up and he's flying around there. He could have done all sorts. I thought he was going to slide tackle their manager at one point. And I think we should have got a decision. And the referee went, no. He went absolutely fucking mental. I've never seen anything like it. I mean, Jesus Christ. The passion on the block is amazing, amazing.
The transformation with George Friend and Ayala in that back four. It's like you say, I'm enjoying watching George again.
Yeah, I still think he's poor. Every chance he gets, he loves to chop inside, doesn't he? He absolutely loves it. And he doesn't get through it once, does he? He tries it and he doesn't get through him. Stop trying it! Honestly, but joking aside, he looks more solid. The back four look more solid. Fair enough, Randolph let that goal in. But the back four and the keeper, we look a unit again. We've got a spine again. What's one thing we had when we went up? We had a spine. And we've got that back. It's exciting again, isn't it?
And Bamford, score sheet again.
Well, yeah. I mean, Jesus Christ, what's that keeper doing? He must have saw the ball coming. He went, oh, well, I'll get there to make it look like, yeah, I tried. But, yeah. And also, he hit his knee, you saw his face, and he was like, well, when you looks in, you looks in. You know what I mean? Was it 8 goals in 5?
top goals in four now, Steve.
8 goals in four. That's even better, isn't it? You know what I mean? He's our top scorer now. We've just got to keep going. One game at a time. Next stop, Brentford. Fair enough, there's an international break in between, but we are on a roll.
You've said to me all season, Steve, we're going up. Are we going up?
Yeah, we are. Bring on Wembley. Bring on being on Wembley Way. That'll be a fucking hoot.
Steve, thanks for coming on Vodafone TV.